I hope you all follow the generative AI content during Ticket. There are a couple of sessions that you should definitely check out if you're interested in AI. Jumpstart your document processing use case with generative AI with Tobias Weller and Tomasz Janasz is definitely worth watching. And you should also check out Power the Future of Your Business with Generative AI by Johannes Hoffart and Matthias Brenner. And of course, the developer keynote with lots of AI, ranging from supporting CAP development to vector store Kana and retrieval augmented generation with the Generative AI Hub on AI Core. For those of you who want to learn more, and especially the basics, check out the Open SAP course, Generative AI at SAP. The course started this week, and the course features Sean Kass, Kadi Harris, and Jana Richter, and many more, who are all experts in the field. And over the next 5 weeks, the course will teach you different approaches to AI, from classic machine learning to generative AI, and you will also see use cases and learn how to leverage AI in your own applications. So enjoy!
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, and today is Yellow Hat Day. In other news, Florian Wall has posted his regular quarterly BTP ABAP environment release blog post, which gives us a very good overview of all of the new features in release 2311. Some notable items here are the new OData Service Consumption Model 2.0, which brings some nice improvements to the Service Consumption Model object. We have new read-only tree views for Fiori elements, some new enhancements to ABAP development tools, as well as some new enhancements to the ABAP RESTful application programming model, and much, much more. Check out Florian's blog post for more details about all the new features in 2311. And as I mentioned, the service consumption model got some love with the 2311 release, and Bernard Cruz has posted a blog post as well that goes into detail about the service consumption model in general and highlights some of the improvements and enhancements. So make sure to check out Bernard's blog post today.
Did you know that you can easily deploy your Docker images from the CF command line interface? We specify our Docker image and our instance requirements in the CF push command, and it will create the service for us in SAP BTP. You need to deploy multiple images? Invoke the CF push command and specify a manifest.yaml file. Within the manifest.yaml file, you can include the different requirements for your containers, for example, environment variables, memory, disk usage. Just like that, we've deployed three different containers to SAP BTP.
Last weekend, the new quarterly version of the SAP Analytics Cloud was released. The product management team did a great job publishing a post that highlights all the features of this new release. Personally, I would like to bring your attention to what's new in the Story extensibility. Story developers can now create a composite widget, which is a reusable building block that can be consumed like any other standard widget in Stories. Composites are stored in the file repository as an artifact, allowing you to transport it to another tenant. The use of composites will help speed up development time. Story developers can now as well create custom add-ons for built-in widgets. The difference between a custom widget and a widget add-on is the custom widgets are built from scratch, whereas the widget add-on customization is built on top of an existing chart. Widget add-ons will be helpful in cases where only a certain part of widgets needs to be customized, such as tooltips or plot areas. Please check the links in the description for the complete list of features, detailed explanations, and recorded demos.
With more systems, APIs, and events coming together in various constellations these days, both generally and in your own landscape, it's more important than ever to know and to be able to programmatically discover what applications and services there are, what resources they offer, and how they can be integrated. Enter the Open Resource Discovery Protocol. It's a protocol that was born inside of SAP, but has been recently released under the Apache 2 open source license. With the Open Resource Discovery Protocol, applications and services can describe their own capabilities, including not only the obvious candidates such as APIs and events, but also aspects such as entity types, data products, and integration dependencies. The Open Resource Discovery Protocol doesn't replace any existing protocols and formats such as OData or OpenAPI. Rather, it complements them. Check out all the details in Simon's blog post, where there's also a link to various videos with more information.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. We would like to draw your attention to a new learning journey that was recently launched on learning.sap.com. It is about building SAP Fiori Elements apps based on OData V4 services built with the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model. In this journey, you can learn all about the SAP Fiori tools, the available floor plans, as well as annotations, leveraging the metadata-driven approach of SAP Fiori Elements. And the best thing is, the learning journey is completely free of charge. If you already know SAP Fiori Elements, you know that the underlying technology is SAP UI5. And SAP UI5 will be part of SAP Build Code that was recently announced at SAP TechEd. Check out this blog post by Oliver, who gives a nice overview of SAP Build Code and all the front-end technologies that it includes. See you. Bye.